Hi everyone. Well, today we're going to talk about how to prune zucchini. So whether you're a beginning gardener or have been growing your own food for a long time, zucchini is a great plant to have in your backyard garden because it is such a power producer. It will produce a lot of food for you in a relatively short period of time. If you missed my video on how to grow zucchini, I'll put a pop-up link above because you definitely want to have this growing in your backyard. But it is prone to a disease called powdery mildew. It tends to get a little bit out of control, as you can see from my plant right here. But there's a few little pruning tips that will help you keep it under control and to help keep powdery mildew at bay. Now, as I mentioned, one reason to prune your zucchini is to help stop the spread of powdery mildew. If you're not familiar with powdery mildew, it's a very common disease that just about any gardener gets every summer, and it tends to happen in really wet conditions, although here I have really dry conditions and I still get it at the end of every summer. But it basically starts off as little fuzzy patches on your leaves, and it's best to really prune them off and to get rid of them so it doesn't spread throughout your garden. And I like to start with a nice sharp pair of pruning shears, but I do like to clean them as I move from plant to plant to help stop the spread of disease. And the way I do this is just a little bit of alcohol, put it on a cotton swab, just like so, and just rub it on my pruning shears to help keep them nice and clean and sterile as I move from plant to plant. And when you're pruning your zucchini plant, you want to make sure you have gloves on because it is a really prickly plant and you don't want to hurt your hands. But I like to wait until my stem is about 3 feet long. And you can see here, this plant is actually growing over my wall here because it's kind of downhill. And I'm going to be pruning off all of these old leaves that are kind of brown. Does have some insect damage, and that's a really good place to start because that's usually where the powdery mildew starts, is on the older leaves first. So let me go ahead and show you how to get these pruned off. So not only is my stem about 3 feet long, but this zucchini plant has been producing for several months now. So cutting off any of these old yellowing leaves is definitely not going to affect production. And it's super easy to do. All you do is just get your pruners as close as you can to the main stem of the plant. Just snip it off like this. And you do want to make sure that you get rid of your leaf, not into the compost pile, but into the trash can, because if it does have any disease, you definitely don't want it going into the compost pile. So I'm going to go ahead and get the rest of this plant trimmed up, and then I'll come back and show you how nice the plant looks. Well, I've got my zucchini plant all trimmed up, got all these old yellowing leaves off, and little bonus here, I uncovered a nice little basil plant. It's going to get more sun without those old leaves hanging over it, and I'll have more basil to take inside to my garden. And getting those old leaves off will definitely also help with airflow, which will help keep that powdery mildew at bay. Now, if you are having problems with powdery mildew in your garden, make sure you watch the video that's going to pop up right above here on a really simple milk spray that you can use on your plants to help keep the powdery mildew at bay. If you'd like more in-depth growing information on zucchini, it is one of the featured vegetables in my new ebook, and you want to check that out over on my website under the My Products tab. So comment down below, let me know how zucchini is growing in your garden. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you on the next video.
Not a super big plant yet, and I like to plant it when it's kind of small, when I start it in these cups, because once it gets too big, the roots are just too deep in this cup, and zucchini squash really doesn't like to have its roots.